Hey, hello everyone, welcome back to the channel. And today we are going to do a basic keying setup in Nuke. So as you can see, I have this footage. I will also provide you the website where I download this. If you go this website, the Peter is sharing a lot of free materials for the practice. So as you can see, these are all the shots. Every shot you get a plate and a back plate, and as you can see, there are a lot more shots you can do to improve your compositing. In this tutorial, I'm using this one. In this shot, we have this plate and we have this CG building and we have this back plate also. So as you can see in my Nuke, I will show you. So this is the CG element we have. And this is the drone shot is providing, and this is the CG part. And if I merge, so I did a basic comp setup for this background. So this is the keying part where I'm going to show you the exact keying setup so you can apply any of these downloaded shots. So as you can see, first thing we have to make a soft mat and core mat. So as you can see in my script, I made a soft mat and a core mat. So what I did here, I take this footage and I did white balance, and then I'm making a clean plate. So by the way, this is node I downloaded from the Wikipedia. This is one of my friend created. So you can use IBK stack. As you can see, they both are the same, but this one is very quick, so it's very useful and making your script very clean, as you can see. And so this is the basic IBK soft key, as you can see. So as you can see, key, and here I'm using a primat to make my hard key basically, as you can see. So this is my hard key and I'm just blurring inside and I'm merging together. So if I gamma down, as you can see, if I disable this, so my hard key is filling the inside. So basically it's a core key and soft key is combining, you get your alpha, as you can see. And I'm doing some roto to fill out the extra part, because in some frame, if I show you, like if I off this one, you will see this kind of issue footage itself. So I think they are cleaning the markers and all that, so that's why this footage is getting like this. So no, don't worry, fixing with the roto in one frame. This is very simple footage, by the way. So it's very, there is not much going on here, but this is very good to grab every footage and do a practice basically. It will definitely improve your compositing, keying related, and also the CG. After we are making the alpha, we need to despill this one. So just like in the alpha making, we have soft key and the core key. We have edge despill and the core despill. First of all, I'm doing overall despill, edge despill. So as you can see, I'm taking this orange color because it's closely matching to the skin and in this and this part also, but his cloth is different. So what I did here, I key mix, I did a separate despill for these edges. So as you can see, if I disable this one, before it's getting this orange color, which is not correct. So now it's getting this gray color, which is matching closely to this current edge color. And then what I'm doing, I'm using this same despill I'm putting here, and I'm key mixing edge despill and core despill with the same alpha we just created here. So as you can see, if I zoom here, you will see the difference. As you can see, the core color is changing here. So what I can do, I can put a grade node here and I can change the core color how I want without affecting the edge despill. As you can see, we want to make a core color neutral as possible. So as you can see, so there's a lot of spill here. So in my case, I set this to orange. So I'm key mixing these together. And the last step is we need to add the original luminance back to this despill image. So what I mean by that, if I compare this thing, as you can see, the luminance is changing. What you can do, we can find the exact missing luminance from the despill and the original plate. What you can do, you can take a one merge node and you can do a from. This is the exact missing despill. Don't look at the color. If I desaturate this one, you will see this is the luminance we are missing here and here also. Desaturation, and then you can plug this one on top. So as you can see, now do AB from the input itself. As you can see, the luminance is exactly the same. Okay, after that I'm copying the original alpha here in the pipe, and then I'm doing a premult. So now we are getting premulted FG. We have some issues here, we can fix it later. In the down, I'm just using this checkerboard to check the FG. So as you can see, if I merge this on the checkerboard, as you can see, we have this result, which is not very good, especially in the motion blur area. So as you can see, you see a lot of edge issues and all that. So I made a one tool, so on this one, it will fix a lot of things here. As you can see, it's basically adding this PG color into these edges, As you can see in the edges, you can see the checkerboard. It's basically the edge blending. You don't have to worry about now. We are just focusing on the alpha and all that. And if I disable all these things here, and this is my this thing, if I merge this one on top, so this is the basic comp we have now. And if you check here, he's basically adding a lens flare in, and he also grading this FG plate also, because if you check here, this is looking like HDR. I mean, this is also very bright and this is also very bright. You can't see two bright things at once. You need to grade the BG or the plate. As you can see here, he adding also this sun and lens flare. He grading the FG plate. We have to do a lot of adjustment for the background also. For now, what I did here, I just put a defocus, just normal defocus, but we also provided a depth pass, so we can add a depth, so we can add a defocus also here. But for now, I added a normal defocus to just make the slapcomp. So as you can see, this is my slapcomp now. I will provide you this file in the video description, so you can download and check the whole script again. And thank you for watching. This is very quick overview of the keying setup. And make sure you do your soft key and a core key. Combine them together. Then you have to do the same thing for the edge despill and the core despill. And you have to key mix them together. Make sure to use key mix when you mixing edge despill and a core despill like that. Thank you so much for watching. If you have any questions, anything related to the keying and any other topic, please let me know in the comment below. I will definitely try to help you. Again, thank you for watching. See you in a very next one.